YouTube, Michigan Snow Pony Renee. And today I want to talk about something that doesn't get discussed a lot when it comes to planning out your homestead. You know, a lot of people, they think about where they're going to put the house, or the barns, or the pasture, or the orchard, or the gardens. But something that they don't think about is, where are you going to put the fun? Let's talk about that today. Now, something that I get asked a lot about is, how do we go on vacation? And the short answer is, we don't, at least not easily. And I think that's pretty common among many homesteaders. And it's not a bad thing, because what you end up usually doing, or doing a lot, is taking staycations instead of vacations. And because the problem with taking a vacation is you just have trouble getting away. Number one, it might be a financial thing. A lot of people are cutting way down when they get on their homestead. Maybe they're going down to one income. Maybe they're going down to part-time income. Maybe they're homesteading in retirement. Anyway, the finances just usually aren't there like they were maybe in a previous life. And the other thing is finding suitable caretakers for your homestead, especially if you have livestock. If you have a variety of livestock, it might be difficult to find people that are comfortable with everything you have. And, you know, you can't have goats that go unmilked, or people that are uncomfortable around larger livestock like your horses and won't recognize when they're sick, or whatever the case may be. So that becomes problematic in itself. And sometimes there's just tasks, different part or times of the year that prevent you from leaving. You know, in the spring, you've got animals delivering young. You've got to get the garden in and planted. Summer, you've got to keep up the garden. Maybe you've got to make hay or go buy hay. And summer's a prime time to do all those projects that you want to get done, you know, because of the longer daylight and the weather cooperates. Fall, you've got to harvest and preserve all that garden and orchard produce. Maybe you've got meat animals to process, or you go hunting for most of your meat in the fall. You've got to get the wood in for the winter. You know, you can see the problems. Winter, it might not even be good to leave. Maybe when you want to go on vacation, you're in the middle of a snowstorm or an ice storm and you can't get out of the house. Plus, I don't know about you, but I always worry about the water freezing up while I'm gone. And speaking of that, it's just plain hard to leave and not worry so that you enjoy yourself, at least for me. So the other option is, as I mentioned before, staycations, where you stay at home and you enjoy the property that you've worked so hard to get on and maintain. And, you know, that's going to save you money. You can take care of your animals and your place yourself, and you can incorporate some, you know, catch-up time with overdue tasks or to get that project done that you've been meaning to do while you're off. So it's a good option. But to that end, you've got to think about it as far as incorporating fun into your homestead design. So while you're planning where the house and the garden and the orchard and etc. is going to go, think about where you can incorporate fun. Now let's just talk about a few of those things. The number one thing that pops into my mind is farm ponds. I mean, they are so versatile. You can fish in them, you can swim. If they're big enough, you can do boating or kayaking. And if you live in a northern climate, you've got ice skating and ice fishing in the winter. If you can't get a farm pond put in for one reason or another, maybe your property's not big enough, maybe you don't have the right soil, and I know we're lacking a clay layer here, how about just an above-ground pool? You know, it used to be those were expensive options, but one company, Intex, comes to mind. They make all kinds of them, and they're very reasonable. I picked up one at the end of season. I think it was like a 15-foot across one, 4 or 5 feet deep, for $79, and that lasted us 5 years. And we got a lot of good out of that pool. So above-ground pools are not out of the reach of most people, especially if you wait till the end of summer and you buy them on clearance. Another option you may not have heard of are natural pools. And people are really liking these because you get away from the chemicals. You use natural planting areas, a shallow area around the perimeter of the pool with plants, and you use UV light hitting the water, and that you do away with the chlorine. They're really cool, and they fit into a lot of landscaping very nicely. They look nice. Here's some pictures so you can get an idea. How about camping on your property? It's not as outlandish as it seems, and you don't need acres and acres, just maybe a little secluded place. Maybe you've got a small woodlot that you can't do anything else with or haven't thought of anything else to do with it. How about putting up a little outfitter's tent? Look at what Mary Jane's farm does. She actually rents these out as bed and breakfast accommodations, and they're pretty cool. Take a look. Now, if an outfitter's tent isn't your cup of tea, how about an old travel trailer or a pop-up? You can find these all the time on Craigslist, really reasonable. And the smaller ones are easy to manage and move around or park on your property for your own little cabin. And you can fix them up with a little elbow grease and some creativity. They're really cute. Check out Glamping, G-L-A-M-P-I-N-G, or Sisters on the Fly for some ideas. Really cool websites and really cool little trailers. And if you've got an old hip roof or Gothic arch barn with a loft in it, oh my gosh, those make great bunk houses for the kids to have sleepovers in. And also, I've seen some people put basketball courts up there for when there's not hay in the barn. That's a great dual-purpose recreational thing to have on your homestead. Got some large trees on your property? How about a deluxe treehouse? Check these out. And you know, a fancy treehouse really isn't a frivolous idea, because there again, it could double as a guest house, a really cool guest house, or a really nice deer blind during hunting season. How about incorporating, speaking of hunting season, a shooting range on your property? If you've got a nice big hill, you could have a sledding hill on one side and a shooting range on the other, you know? Or just a plain old trail system. You know, trails are great for hiking and dirt bikes and go-karts and quad runners and mountain bikes. And in the winter, you could do cross-country skiing and snowshoeing, snowmobiling, or my personal favorite, riding horses year-round. So, you know, if you got some woods or some ground that you don't think you're going to use, think about putting some trails through it. And how about a zip line? Now, I've seen zip lines attached to, like, big old hip roof barns to the ground, or on a hill to the bottom of the hill, or people build towers and they put them between. I mean, you've got to make sure it's safe, but having a zip line on your property, I've seen them over ponds too. Great fun. Now, besides adding to your own property, and maybe that's, you know, far down the line because you've got so much work to do, but another thing you can do for your staycation is to take advantage of what's in the neighborhood. You know, you've probably got area lakes to go to or parks, both natural and amusement. How about miniature or full-size golf courses, if that's something your family enjoys? Check out what fairs and festivals go on in your location. And there's usually always concerts and movies in the park going on in the smaller townships. I know we have the movies in the park here in our little town. Don't forget zoos and animal parks. And for those rainy days, how about a visit to a planetarium or a museum or a movie matinee? You know, not everything has to be done on your homestead. Take advantage of what's in your locale. You put a lot of work, effort, and time into your homestead. So give yourself places to stop and smell the roses once in a while and enjoy it. You know, put up a hammock. How about an outdoor dining area with candle lanterns or miniature lights strung up? How about strategically placing benches and gliders in scenic spots on your homestead, or where you can just relax and enjoy the sights? I personally like to watch chickens. I think they're more relaxing and lower your blood pressure better than an aquarium full of fish. Or maybe you like to watch baby goats frolic around. That's one of my favorite things too. So put a bench by those pens. How about a quiet reading area in the shade, or where you can just take a nap? How about a little gazebo with a farmstead theme, where you can have your lunch or meet with friends, or do whatever you want out there. And don't forget to incorporate a fire pit or a fire ring in the backyard. Add some seating, some tiki torches, maybe a little music, and you've got yourself an evening's of entertainment. Really simple and right on your homestead. So when you're laying things out and you're planning for the future, don't forget to incorporate recreational activities and places on your homestead. And if you do it right, you won't mind taking staycations instead of vacations, even the kids. You know, it's just one more quality of life enhancement that your homestead can give you if you do things right. That's all, YouTube. Bye-bye.